Good evening and welcome. Glad to have you along for this Tuesday edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. Alongside Grant Hill and Clark Kellogg, I'm Brian Anderson. We'll talk to Allie LaForce, who's on the sidelines as well. Hey, Allie.
Hey, Brian. Devin Booker finally playing winning basketball in Phoenix. He said, quote, "This city deserves it. I've been here grinding, trying to get to this point. The team and the culture that we have, this is the best position that we've been in since I've been here to make those dreams come to life."
Man, that's great to see, Allie. Thanks for that. Let's see the stat sheet here for Seth Curry.
And he's taken a small step back offensively. He really hasn't been the same this month as he was earlier on. He's lacking the intensity he had. He needs a new mindset and stop being passive and play with more aggressiveness.
All right, now the opening lineup for Phoenix. Crowder and Ayton, the bigs. Paul and Booker, the talented backcourt. And it's Bridges in at the small forward position. And for Philadelphia, Harris and Embiid, the big men inside. At the two and the three, it's Curry and Thibault. And it's Maxey in at the one. And Grant, how often do players check in on their own stats during a season?
B.A., everybody in the league watches their numbers. Some guys are just willing to admit it.
And it's the Suns to start out. Outside Booker. Pass to Paul. Takes one from 10 feet. Joel Embiid with the board. Inside, Harris. And Harris throws it down.
Tell you what, fellas, like seeing Harris be engaged from there. I mean, refusing to settle for the simple layup. Nice finish.
Here's Paul. Makes the most of the high percentage shot. And Philadelphia has possession. Pass to Harris. To the inside. And then Embiid with the dunk.
Yeah, that's good vision from Harris. I mean, he draws so much attention himself, so he's become a capable passer.
It's stolen by Thibault. The three from Curry connects from downtown.
Coach is loving the ball movement.
A little over a minute gone here in the first quarter. Booker, the pass to Bridges. Now here's Crowder. Pass to Booker. And there's the drive. And he buries his first look.
Some contact can't derail Booker's drive. He's determined to get his shot off.
And while it can hurt you from outside, Devin Booker has a very rounded game with his shot.
Yeah, last few years, Booker has taken more mid-range jumpers. He feels comfortable pulling up from anywhere in the half court. I mean, he's learning to take whatever the defense gives him.
Paul, bearing his second of three attempts.
Tell you what, it's really remarkable to see it. Just about 6 feet tall, and that might be generous. Chris Paul is a dominant player in the painted area, and he does it with skill and craftiness.
And it's good. 2 points. Embiid's got his second basket.
Just taking it right to the rim, and no one was there to greet him.
Well, this early, they should be showing a lot more energy on defense. It's not there.
Now here's Crowder. Checking his numbers, he's put up a little over 9 points a game.
They've hit four of their first five shots. Great execution and attention to detail.
Here's Embiid. It's a three-point game. To the middle. Shoots over Ayton. And that one goes in as he's fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts the free throw. All right, guys, some stats here. The scoring breakdown for the 76ers.
You know, guys, we've really seen them do a lot of damage in the paint so far.
Another aspect of their game that's been super so far tonight is how they've been sharing the ball and piling up the assist.
The free throw drops for Embiid.
You know, many people refer to Embiid as the best big in the league right now, and largely because there isn't a hole in his game. I mean, he does a lot of everything, and as big as he is, his agility and shooting touch is off the chart.
And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Paul. It's February. Let's see how things are shaping up in the East. Taking a look at the 76ers, they're in fifth place, right in the middle of the conference. Still time to improve that positioning.
Well, right now for the 76ers, they've stayed within arm's length of the conference leaders. That in itself is an accomplishment at this point in the season.
You know, I thought maybe they'd have it in them to actually join those leaders this season. But you're right, it's still nice work considering where they are.
Six on the shot clock. Here's Harris. And Harris throws it down.
There's no way you can minimize his concentration. Excellent focus in finding a way to score that time by Harris.
And how about our AT&T 5G slam cam? Couldn't have captured that play any better. And Clarky, look at the evolution of Embiid's game. Really speaks to his intense work ethic.
I agree with you because he's had several injuries now, and yet he has not wasted that time rehabbing because he's developed his skills in the process. He said surgeries after surgeries, at some point I wanted to quit, but his heart was too big for that, and his game is showing the fruit of his work.
Booker, good.
Pass first mindset of Paul. When you leave somebody open on his squad, he's going to make you pay for it.
Pass to Maxey. Back to Embiid. Shoots over Paul. Embiid gets the bucket. Embiid's got nine.
An outstanding first quarter from the field.
You're exactly right. I mean, everything seems to be dropping. Impressive scoring here.
Paul against Embiid. For three, Bridges. Gets the three to fall.
Defensively, you have to stay connected to him on the perimeter.
The Sixers leading. And the 76ers call time here. Their first chance to take a look at the Suns this season.
Last season, they got swept in a two-game season series against this opponent. I'm sure they're looking for payback tonight.
And, you know, they might not be in the same conference, but as with any top team, they want to show they can compete with the best teams out of conference, too.
And the 76ers will have a different look here. Andre Drummond is checked in for Joel Embiid. Korkmaz comes in for Thibault. Green's checked in for Curry. And Milton subbed in for Maxey. Green finds Drummond. And that comes off the assist by Green.
Yeah, they call him Dancing Danny Green, and you can see why. Excellent offensive instincts there.
And McGee with the stuff.
Seems to have a knack for hitting guys in their spots. His vision, excellent.
Green against Booker. Left side, Milton. Drummond against Johnson. Shakes off strong D and gets to the bucket for 2 points.
There's really not much else you can do against Drummond. Man. He's skilled at looking past defenders to get to the finish.
Here's Šarić. Nice start for him. Sinking his first shot.
Getting enough shots in close to play inside out.
Booker against Green. 1:10 left in the first quarter here. Pass to Korkmaz. Back to Milton. Shoots over McGee. The Suns clear it. Well, they put up a nice win against Chicago last time out.
Sometimes it's difficult to get good looks on the road, but they ran the offense brilliantly.
And it was funny, the road arena didn't bother them at all. I mean, they locked in, focused, and executed, and got it done.
Here's Green. The Suns getting their last shot to go. Pass to Korkmaz. Is the glass on the layup.
I know it's early, but you have to wonder if these offenses can keep this up.
High octane action for sure. Crowd pleasing already.
And there it is for him. Booker's got his third basket on the night right there.
They have no answer defensively inside.
Yeah, and that's four straight field goals now they've allowed from point blank range. Can't happen.
Here's Harris. Again, the Sixers score.
A real comfort zone for Harris. I mean, he's looking to score often from this area.
Here's Paul. And the Suns getting another bucket right there. Joel Embiid, he's feeling it tonight and has been the driving force for Philadelphia, hunting for opportunities, leading to 9 points in the quarter. We'll be right back. And he's always been a coach on the floor. Chris Paul is a communicator.
With anything, whether it's business, work, relationships, whatever, it's communication. And I think that's something that we're doing an amazing job of right now. And that's communicating, talking through things, and making sure, even when it gets tough, that we continue to communicate.
CP3, never shy, Grant.
Never shy indeed. Always holding himself and his teammates accountable.
And it's been a pretty even game here after one quarter of play. And looking at what we've seen from the Sixers, what do you guys think?
Oh, what I love was that first quarter was all about leaking out and capitalizing in transition.
Yeah, I like the way they play. They're looking to get up and down the court every time. Racehorse basketball here tonight. Strap it up. Don't look down. You'll miss something.
On the court right now, second quarter for the Suns. Ball and Booker, the talented backcourt. Dario Saric is out there with Johnson. And it's Kaminsky in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. Now here's Drummond. He's got six. And Harris gets it to go on the assist by Drummond. And now it's a 7-point Philadelphia lead. Well, Grant, at this point in his career, I think it's safe to say Andre Drummond will go down as one of the game's premier rebounders.
Yeah, you just don't call him a specialist because there's a lot more to Drummond's game than just rebounding. Rim protection, points in the paint. He does just about everything you want in a big man. When he's on the floor, he lightens the load on every other member of their front court.
Clock at six. Here's Harris. And the 76ers tack on two more.
And you know, this team relies on Tobias Harris to score the ball, especially from these spots on the floor.
To the paint. Here's Saric. Nice dish, and the layup goes down. Saric has got his second basket of the game.
Credit their discipline. They've been working for high percentage shots.
And Philadelphia calls time here. And in the league today, we've got some all-time greats playing out on the wing. But who do you think the best wing in the NBA is right now, Grant?
Oh, boy, you're trying to get me in trouble. That's a tough one. I mean, you have LeBron, you have Giannis, you have Kawhi, KD. All of them are elite. All of them are champions. So if I had to choose, I guess I'll go with, I don't know. They're just all great.
And the 76ers will have a different look here. Joel Embiid, he's checked in for Drummond. Thibault comes in for Tobias Harris. Curry, he's checked in for Green. And it's Maxey in for Milton. Ayton, he's checked in for the Suns. Bridges comes in for Johnson. Now here's Thibault. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game from him. Pass to Embiid. Hey, in six attempts, he's made five. Talk about efficiency.
Embiid has such balance and agility for a big man. He's able to work through contact and still finish with touch.
For three, Booker. It's good. The assist that time from Paul. Paul's got five assists tonight.
He's a producer. It's part of their plan to get him as many touches as possible.
Embiid, good.
All game long, he's been getting to his spots, and the defense has yet to adjust.
And he lobs it up, and he lays in the alley-oop pass.
And what a passer Paul is. Exceptional at seeking out his guys and getting them into a rhythm.
Here's Maxey. He's guarded by Paul. Elbow shot on the way, and the 76ers tack on two more.
And, you know, he's going to take that shot every time. The defense has to respect him from the mid-range.
It's Booker on the wing. Here in the second quarter, just under 3.5 minutes played. And Paul gets it to go.
And, you know, coaches will take possessions like that all day long. Phenomenal use of the screen there.
Curry against Booker. He's in his comfort zone. 2 for 2 to start this one.
Wow. They're really being taken advantage of defensively out there. No rim protection whatsoever.
Pass to Paul. Ayton with it. Takes the assist and lays it in. Nice setup. Ayton's got his second basket on the night.
They are passing the ball around tremendously right now.
Let's a floater go. Maxey, that's good.
Boy, that was a sweet-looking teardrop. There's very little defense for that.
Down low. Here's Paul. Yes, and it's Booker with the setup. Booker's got 3 assists now in this one.
Yeah, you can tell Paul is amped up on offense now, getting aggressive and going after a lot of shots. He's hunting his looks, and that's a dangerous place to be if you're defending.
Maxey, that's good.
No defensive pressure at all. I mean, that's not going to get it done against him.
Paul passes to Booker. Paul finds Booker. Again gets it to go. He can't miss. 5 for 5.
They're playing great team basketball. It's good movement and sharp, crisp passing.
Purposeful passing it is, partner. Their last 10 points have all come off assists.
And the 76ers call time here. Drummond's checked in for Korkmaz. McGee, he's checked in for the Suns. Crowder comes in for Kaminsky. Pass to Thybul. Back to Drummond. Outside Curry. 5 on the clock. Wing shot on the way. And he connects with a jumper. Curry's got 4 points this quarter. There's 1:34 left in the first half.
Well, you know, just like his brother, Seth Curry shoots with tremendous range and remarkable efficiency. And the old man wasn't too bad in those categories either. Odell could put it in the hole from deep with a high rate of efficiency, too.
Embiid, good.
Well, you know, there's only so much you can do against Embiid, guys. I mean, he's such a terrifically skilled offensive player with great size. I mean, he plays pretty much through any kind of contact.
Paul, and that one drops. Paul's got 14 points for the game.
No misses for him yet in this quarter. Solid as a rock.
Outside Curry. Pass to Maxey. With the 10-footer, and it's off the back of the rim. No good. The Suns trailing. Bridges outside. 34 seconds left in the first half of this one. A nice shot by McGee.
Hey, there's a reason why he shoots such a high percentage, guys. I mean, he picks smart shots, high-quality shots, in close shots that he takes.
Here's Maxey. Give him 8.
Now that's a textbook alley-oop.
I thought he'd go for the slam, but that worked.
It actually almost makes it a little more special. Grace over power is how I would look at it.
And he lobs it up to the rim. McGee and Joel Embiid pulls it down. To the paint. Here's Drummond. And he banks in the layup. And now a 6-point Philadelphia lead.
And, you know, Drummond has no problem playing through contact. He excels at using that strong body of his to fight through contact and finish.
And so it's the Philadelphia 76ers with a 6-point lead at the close of the quarter. And
breakdowns on defense, we got to recognize personnel. We've given up a few open shots to the guys we've talked about. We'll be better as we go forward. We got to get out and run, but our defense will help us run more.
Thanks, Allie. After the break, we'll see you right back here to begin quarter number three.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
It was Joel Embiid who got hot in the first. He ended up with 17 points and 2 rebounds. And from what we saw so far from the Sixers, Kenny, what's your takeaway?
This is what the home fan loves to see. Their squad coming out and putting together strong performance. We'll see a couple individuals stand out. But what really stand out is how hard they work and how they're playing together.
Shaq, what'd you think about Phoenix?
Hard to feel happy when your opponent's shooting over 60%. You're going to have to make things harder for those guys defensively. Force them out of their comfort zone. Contest every shot.
And if you're just joining us, we played through the first half in a game that's been fairly even so far. What else can you say? Joel Embiid, an impressive effort here today.
Through the first two quarters, he's been on fire. Explosive offensive performance.
And you know what? I'll be interested to see just how much he's got left in the tank. That first half had to take a lot out of.
We've got second half action for you. And if the next couple of quarters are similar to the first, this one could go down to the last possession. At the 2 and the 3, it's Curry and Thibault. The dynamic duo of Harris and Embiid at the 4 and the 5. And it's Maxey in at the point guard position. That's Doc Rivers 5 as we get into the second half. Now here's Thibault. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard.
He gets the upper hand and lays it in. Defense needs to toughen up.
Here's Bridges, trailing by 8. Paul for 3, drains the triple.
Paul is a more than capable 3-point shooter now. He does not need much separation either to get off his shot.
Here's Maxey. He's guarded by Paul. On the wing, Curry. It's good. Curry's got 9.
How about the level of concentration by Seth Curry? Even when he's guarded in the paint, his focus is on the basket.
Outside Paul. Over Embiid. Paul finds Ayton. Oh, and the jam by Ayton!
He's doing his best to carry him, fellas, but he can only do so much. Things would be different for them if he was getting a little more help.
Here's Maxey. He's covered by Ayton. Stolen by Ayton. It's a one-on-one situation. Here's Paul. Oh, and the jam by Ayton.
And when the game is this close, you have to go all out.
He certainly understands his role, huh? When the shot goes up, just crashes the offensive glass.
You know, that time I thought he did it with authority. Tremendous putback at a time when they really need it.
Green's checked in for the Sixers. Milton comes in for Maxey. Johnson, he's checked in for the Suns. 2 minutes gone in this third quarter now. Crowder outside. Outside Johnson. Here's Ayton. Yep, that one's good.
Timeout.
He's got 10.
On fire to start the second half. 4-5 from the field.
And the 76ers call time here. And now that they have some time to get a little bit of rest, it's time for these players to regroup while hydrating themselves with some Gatorade, looking to gain a boost of energy as they continue to play in this game.
And staying hydrated is the only surefire way to do it. An athlete's body doesn't have the same power and stamina without proper hydration. These guys will be sure to use this timeout wisely.
Šarić checks in for the Suns. And while we have a second, let's take a quick peek at the rebounding numbers for Andre Drummond.
It's not a great trend for him. not rebounding nearly as effectively anymore. Maybe it's his effort, or who knows, but that's something that needs to change.
That's tipped. It's stolen by Šarić. And the Suns pushing it up now. Paul passes to Ayton. Up high and down it goes on the lob.
A great read between those two guys. The defense didn't stand a chance, B.A.
These two teammates right here, Grant, they are connected.
And I tell you what, guys, that's a big play to make in a close game. Potential momentum builder there.
Now here's Embiid. He's got 17. And that's basket number 9 for him. He's 9 for 10.
Excellent execution coming out of the break. They've taken 3 shots and made 3 shots. We talk about Embiid's surge in production, but it doesn't end there. He said, I want to push my teammates to be better and lead by example.
Booker against Green. Pass to Harris. Outside Thybul, 6 to shoot. Embiid's got space. And he gets the friendly roll as that one goes. And it's a 3-point Philadelphia lead. And many great players eventually realize that we is greater than me.
Yeah, Embiid's main point to this team is play the right way, because that's what you can control. He is intelligent, vocal, and selfless.
We've gone about 3.5 minutes here into the third. Embiid misses.
He expects to make every one of those, and we expect him to make them too.
Oh, Harris with the block.
What a block from Harris. Terrific work there.
And Embiid throws it down.
Transition basketball, the most reliable way to generate easy looks.
Yep, exactly. And if there's any opportunity for early offense, you've got to push it and push it every time.
Now here's Ayton. 12 points for him. Knocks it loose. Thybul with a steal. And the shot goes. And a moment here to take a look at some hustle stats for Philadelphia.
Defensively, they've played with a high energy level tonight. And all the steals we've seen, a result of that aggressiveness.
They haven't wasted time getting the ball up the court tonight either. And it's resulted in a lot of fast break points.
And Phoenix has possession. After the Sixers picked up a basket a moment ago. Shot clock at 2. Here's Booker. And again, it's the Suns missing.
You got to move past that one. I mean, they'd want him to take that again.
Well, you know, I hear you. That's a good look. But when you're that wide open, I think you got to knock it down.
And he's coming off a huge performance, and his confidence couldn't be any higher. And his coach knows that, too.
Showing no signs of slowing or cooling down. They're going to ride him as far as he can take it.
Here's Booker following the score by Philadelphia. And it's Harris with the rebound.
Well, you will not see that from him very often, especially right at the rim.
Green, the pass to Embiid. And Embiid gets the double team. And he makes it. And now an 8-point 76ers lead.
They're really working the paint now.
They're searching for a way to score.
Yeah, buckets have been very tough to come by.
Phoenix calls timeout.
And for those of you who have followed Harris, he's been in the league a decade now. Doesn't seem like it's been that long, but it has been, and he's rock solid.
And a new group getting ready for the Sixers. Drummond's checked in for Embiid. Korkmaz comes in for Thybul. Curry, he's checked in for Green. And it's Maxey in for Milton. Now here's Smith. And he's going for the oop here. Stolen away. Nice job to interrupt the alley-oop attempt. Back to Harris. Fires from deep. And the 76ers another 3. And over his 10 years, Clark, Harris has been remarkably reliable.
Yeah, he's as consistent as they come, B.A. He's going to score the ball. He'll rebound.
Oh, hey, how about that?
Big time right there. Big time.
Woo. An explosive offensive force. When Booker has the chance to slam it, he takes full advantage.
There's the AT&T 5G Slam Cam, capturing the moment. Here's Maxey, Booker defending. And the 76ers tack on 2 more.
Credit them for making the right halftime adjustments.
You know, they came out of the locker room, revved up the gas pedal, and haven't slowed down yet.
Johnson passes to McGee. Again gets it to go. He can't miss. 5 for 5.
You just can't give up looks that close to the rim.
6 second difference between the shot clock and game clock. Here's Harris. And here's another one for the Sixers.
He's lighting them up. Tough to strategize a comeback when you're being run over.
Curry against Booker. Gets to the rim for two with the D all over him. Booker's got 15.
A really nice play by Booker. I mean, he gives you size out of the backcourt and can finish with either hand.
And so it's the Philadelphia 76ers with a 9-point cushion at the end of the quarter. Getting lots of great looks, shooting it well. That's why they're up. We'll be right back with you shortly. Moment ago, head coach Doc Rivers in the huddle.
Hey, guys, come on. Let's close this door. Let's close it. Got to pick up our pace. Got to pick up our pace right here.
And Doc Rivers looking for a faster tempo, wanting to make a big push here.
Well, he realizes when his team is attacking at both ends, that's when they tend to go on runs.
Fourth quarter action is upon us. Thanks, as always, for joining us. On the court for the Suns, getting the fourth quarter going. Devin Booker out there with Jay Crowder. Then it's Mikal Bridges. Then there's JaVale McGee. And it's Smith in at the power forward position. Pass to Harris. Up and over Smith. Harris's shot is good. Harris has got 9 points now in the second half.
Tell you what, seems like everything he's putting up is finding the net. And right now, Harris is simply balling out.
Here's Booker. The shot comes out. And Philadelphia the other way now. And at home for the next one, it'll be Oklahoma City pulling in. It'll be the second game of four straight at home.
That's a move you won't see many guys make. Impressive stuff.
Outside Booker. Pass to Bridges. Banked it in off the glass.
Man, that's now 10 straight points in the paint.
I'm not sure what's happened to their defense, man.
I think they've really got to start committing more bodies down low and really kind of close that area off defensively.
The kick out, Curry. And there's the lob. McGee with a steal. All alone on the break. Here's Bridges. Drummond grabs the miss. The Sixers leading. To the inside, Harris. And he floats it in for the easy two. Credit the sweet setup on that one.
A precision passer, Curry, also excellent at seeing his guys when they're open.
Smith passes to Bridges. Back to Smith. Very pretty alley-oop.
Just a perfect pass and some pretty slick body control on the finish, too.
Man, that's butter.
He could have messed that up trying for a big slam. Nice work going to the layup.
Pass to Drummond. Back to Milton. Shoots over Bridges. Milton, no good. For Phoenix, they've gone 3 of 5 since this fourth quarter started. Smith passes to McGee. Crowder outside. Back to Booker. McGee with it. 5 to shoot. Booker, good. Booker's got 19.
And talk about imposing your will. That's 10 straight points in the paint.
Well, constantly finding lanes to the basket, getting great looks inside.
Drummond passes to Harris. Back to Drummond. And the shot is good. Harris making the play. Harris has got his fourth assist with that last one.
Boy, a little contact will not deter Drummond. I mean, he gets physical right back and finishes strong.
Phoenix calls timeout. Coaching turnover is a fact of life in the NBA. Grant, as a player, how tough is it to adapt to a new coach?
Well, it depends on the timing. I mean, an offseason change gives the team a time to get used to a new system. Now, if it happens in midseason, it could be a little tough. The learning curve is definitely steep.
And some changes here for the 76ers. Joel Embiid, he's checked in for Drummond. And it's Thybulle in for Milton. DeAndre Ayton, he's checked in for the Suns. Chris Paul comes in for Smith and let's swing it over to the sideline and hear from Allie.
Thanks, guys. I got a chance to hear what Monty Williams was saying to his team. He really got into them, saying, quote, "You guys aren't playing hard enough. Forget the X's and O's. We need to play with passion. Let's just see that for the last part of this game. Guys."
Appreciate the report, Allie. Harris's shot is good.
Boy, this is the threat that Harris poses now. He's a scorer from every level. Inside, three-point landing at the rim.
Pass to Aiden. Outside Paul. Takes one from 10 feet, and it's Harris with the rebound.
They have a decent advantage in regards to rebounding,
especially when you're scoring the ball at a decent clip the way they have. I mean, they've done exactly what's necessary to take the lead.
Good work there as it goes. And the 76ers lead by 11.
And that's exactly how you attack length. I love how he doesn't lack assertiveness.
That's well done there. I mean, don't even give him a chance to get to the block. Get in tight and finish at the rim.
And he gives up some size inside, but makes a great adjustment on the finish.
You know, with that size difference, that's not an easy shot. I mean, I don't care how close to the rim he is, that's a tough shot.
And Thibault with a drive, and the layup is good off the glass. Thibault's got 4 points in the quarter. For Phoenix, they've gone 6-for-9 here in the fourth quarter. Paul against Harris. Here he goes. Paul with the bucket. Paul's got 26.
Paul, so good with the ball. Carves his way inside with such ease and precision. That's what's so marvelous about it.
Pass to Embiid. Embiid drawing the double team. For three, Maxey. That's basket number 6 in 8 tries.
And just totally relentless, only increasing the intensity level.
Yeah, I love the fact he doesn't play the score. He just keeps coming, attack mode. He doesn't know how to step off the gas pedal.
His arrow's been trending up as of late, and he's been magnificent tonight.
I wasn't quite sure if he'd be able to maintain that same level of play. I had my doubts coming into this game, but consider my doubts disappeared.
And trust me, when the D's slow to react, he'll be the first guy to make them pay.
Boy, the defense looks shell-shocked. I mean, they're on the ropes right now, on their heels.
Pass to Bridges. All sorts of time. And he buries that one. Back rim and in.
One of the reasons they're behind is because we haven't seen enough of that. He needs to become a bigger part of the offense.
Both sides are simply waiting for the clock to make it official. This is going to end up in the books as a nice win for the 76ers.
They were the more accurate club, and in the end, that made the difference, Grant.
Yeah, B.A., you have to love their strategy. And even more, you love the execution.
And they're getting ready to notch their 33rd win of the year.
And with this one all but in the record books, they set the tone in the first of what will be only 2 meetings between these teams.
It sure is. It's just the 2 gamers since they're in opposite conferences. And you can bet they'll take the same approach right into game 2 that they had tonight.
And even the opposing fans can't deny this was a sensational game for Tobias Harris.
Well, I can't recall a play that he wasn't involved in. He was so involved in so many plays tonight. A force on both ends.
Tremendous individual play. I mean, challenging the heart of that defense.
Oh, are you kidding me? Wow,
man. This is what winning is all about. Playing your best when it matters most.
Yeah, you know, once they got victory in their view, a huge injection of energy and a great run to finish it off.
The scoring is coming easy for him. Got to keep the ball in his hands.
Outside Curry. So it's the 76ers winning this one easily. This one was a fun one to watch. They were clearly in the driver's seat down the stretch.
They really were, B.A. They played with great intensity on both ends of the floor, and they didn't allow their mistakes to get the better of them.
All right, now let's check in with Allie LaForce. Allie, what do you have?
Joel, in the past, you've certainly had your critics, and you have not run from them. What are you looking to prove out there?
Just being dominant, so I want every time people hear my name, I want them to know that I'm a dominant player.
Well, you do have the ability to dominate every single night. Good luck moving forward.
Allie, thank you as always. And that'll wrap it up, folks. 4 o'clock.